Hello everyone and welcome to TV Box Top, the channel for the best reviews in TV boxes, mini PCs and accessories. In today's video, I have a Windows 10 mini PC from the brand AEROFARA. This is a compact Windows 10 mini PC that can be upgraded to Windows 11 with some pretty decent specs and a portable design. It's called the AEROFARA Aero 2 Pro, and in this review, we'll examine its hardware and design, I'll attempt to upgrade it to Windows 11, and let's see what tasks we can perform on its operating system and if we can do additional stuff in relation to alternative operating systems such as Android X86 and FydeOS, so stay tuned. And welcome back. In this package contains the Aero 2 Pro mini PC itself. They have included a very high quality HDMI cable, a 12 volts 2 amps DC power adapter, and a user manual that's in English, Dutch, French, Spanish, and Chinese. Its body is made of metal with the AEROFARA chrome logo to the top. It has one HDMI 2.1 port, one USB 3.0 port, one RJ45GB LAN port, a headphone microphone combination jack, a reset button, and the DC power input to its rear. To its right, it has two more USB 3.0 ports, a power button, a standard size SD card slot, and the exhaust vent for the internal cooling fan. On the opposite side, it has a VGA display port and the intake vent. At the front, it has a power LED. And to its base, it has four anti-skid rubber pads. So I'll just take a moment to set this up and continue. So I've connected the PC to my 4K TV through my capture card, and during the Windows first startup wizard, I was prompted to upgrade to Windows 11, which is a nice feature instead of having to do it manually via USB. However, it still boots up into Windows 10, and in the background, Windows Update has it listed as one of the updates. You simply scroll down until you see the download button and click on it to initiate the upgrade. So this PC has been successfully upgraded to Windows 11, and if I open its system information under the About section, here it shows that the model is the Aero 2 Pro. Its CPU is an Intel Celeron N5105, which is a Jasper Lake quad-core CPU, and it's clocked at 2.0 GHz, which is its base clock speed. It has a boost clock speed of 2.9 GHz. It has 8GB of LPDDR4 RAM, and it's a 64-bit operating system. If you scroll down under Product Key and Activation, it shows that the current version of Windows 11 is activated. For a bit more detailed information, it appears that the Ada 64 Extreme app, as well as CPU-Z and GPU-Z, cannot fully detect this PC's chipset, so I turned to Intel's product page and other related pages for more information. Here it shows the Intel Jasper Lake CPU has a base clock speed of 2.0 GHz and a boost clock speed of 2.9 GHz, and overclocking is not allowed. Its GPU is the Intel UHD Graphics 24EU's Jasper Lake GPU, and it shows that the GPU has a frequency between 450 and 800 MHz. These are the codecs supported by this hardware, and I see that AV1 decoding is not supported. However, it does support 4K HDR. Its RAM type is LPDDR4 RAM with a speed of 2933 MHz. Returning now to Ada 64 Extreme, and it shows that the audio adapter is the Intel Jasper Lake Point PCH, and it supports audio, voice, and speech. It comes with a Kimtigo brand 256GB SSD for its internal system disk. It shows that it has dual band Wi-Fi from an Intel Wireless AC 3165 network adapter, and it has Bluetooth support. And below here, you have its BIOS information. And that's its system and hardware information. With this hardware, running on Windows 11, you get features such as 4K 2160p resolution at 60Hz with HDR. you get screen orientation to portrait mode, a feature that is used when applied to vertical monitors. It has a night light mode that blocks out blue light that can be stressful on your eyes. And you get a dual monitor display via the VGA port. For audio options, via HDMI, you only get 2-channel audio, but you can get surround sound audio if you connect a 7.1 USB external sound card. You can also get audio via Bluetooth when connected to a Bluetooth speaker or audio receiver. So this mini PC with such a small form factor based on its hardware is more of a productivity type machine over gaming. This means that it's ideal for office applications, browsing the web, streaming videos, and social media. For productivity type activities, you can install Microsoft Office applications, PDF editing software, and apps used for editing scripts such as Notepad++. You can install your favorite antivirus and anti-malware applications. You can connect a USB webcam and use social media apps such as Facebook, Zoom, Skype, and WhatsApp Web. For streaming, you get 4K 2160p resolution on YouTube. And on streaming apps such as Netflix and Amazon Prime Video, you get HD 4K quality with HDCP protection. It's also showing that it can play Dolby Atmos. I will test for that in a moment. For 4K video playback, I must admit that I'm impressed with the playback performance of this mini PC. Usually, mini PCs this size would struggle to play my list of 4K videos, even with special apps such as the VLC player. To my surprise, using the default movie and TV player, it played all my 4K HDR videos smoothly. There is also an auto HDR feature in the display settings, so it only activates when needed.
And only a win for Barca would be enough. Diego Godin makes it 1-1. Atletico back in this. The Liga title in their hands again. Gold Atletico Madrid.
When I placed it on my 7.1 audio receiver, I was very surprised to see that it produced all the surround sound audio formats including Dolby TrueHD. Just watch as I play my list of videos with surround sound formats.
This is Dolby Atmos, the world's first object-based cinematic audio.
This is the left channel. Next, we have the center.
Here, I'm playing a Netflix video with Dolby Atmos through the receiver, and it also shows that the video plays in Ultra HD 4K. So this confirms that the Aero 2 Pro can produce Dolby Atmos, DTS-X, DTS HD Master Audio, Dolby Surround, and Dolby TrueHD. It also has HDCP 2.2 protection and can play all premium movie services in HD and 4K with surround sound audio. Its GPU is powerful enough to render graphics from some large games at low to medium settings safely without overheating due to its internal cooling fan. This is Destiny 2, a 79GB game from the Steam platform, and it plays on low and medium graphics settings. This is a much smaller game from the Microsoft Store, and as you can see, it plays smoothly without issues. So this demonstrates the power of this mini PC.
Around the track.
Let's take this guy down. Just gotta keep him in your rear view mirror, kid.
Let's now take a look at some benchmarks and where it places on my rankings chart. First, in the NovaBench app that measures RAM and internal storage read and write speeds, the Aero 2 Pro has a RAM copy speed of 14,948 MB/s. Its internal storage has a read speed of 378 MB/s and a write speed of 105. To measure its Wi-Fi and Ethernet LAN speeds, it shows that based on my internet speed of 215 Mbps, the 5 GHz band and the LAN port achieved 100% of my bandwidth. The 2.4 GHz band achieved only 20%. In the Geekbench 5 CPU benchmark, it scored 633 single core and 1,885 multi-core. In the PC version of the AnTuTu benchmark, it scored 222,475. In the 3DMark graphics benchmark, it scored 32,274 in the iStorm Extreme test, 6,326 in the CloudGate test, and 349 in the TimeSpy test. And in the PC Mark 10 comprehensive benchmark, it scored 2,409. This is the score that I used to place boxes on my rankings chart, and let's now see where it places. So the scores are in, and the Aero 2 Pro is at position number 3 in reference to PC Mark 10 benchmark scores, which is a great achievement for this compact mini PC compared to some bigger models. You can view this chart on my blog in full spreadsheet format where you can maximize it and compare various benchmark scores and features. See the link in the description below this video. For alternative operating systems, I was able to run the latest version of Android 12 x86 Snow Cone version via live CD only, as the BIOS blocks you from installing on a partition of its internal storage or on a separate USB or SD card. It's fully operational in live CD with full access to the Google Play Store, and it has CPU clock speed at 2.9 GHz with 64-bit architecture, and it also comes with surround sound audio decoders, which is a first. The downside with running live CD is that you cannot save your installed apps and data once you restart. This is because you cannot install GRUB to its BIOS. With FydeOS, the situation is even worse, where not only that you can't install onto a separate drive via USB or SD card, if you boot into live mode directly from the installation disk, you cannot access the Android subsystem. So in my opinion, it's absolutely useless. In summary, The Aero 2 Pro is a surprisingly efficient mini PC with many positive features compared to other top models. The one major sore point for me is the fact that it does not allow you to install GRUB, so you can install alternative operating systems such as Android x86 and FydeOS. Other than that, this would have been a more complete high-performance mini PC. And with that said, this brings the curtains down on today's review. Special thanks goes out to the AEROFARA brand on Amazon for sending a sample of their product for review. If you would like to check out this mini PC, I placed a link in the description where you can find it on Amazon and AliExpress. I would also like to thank you, my viewers, for your continued support by watching my videos, your continuous thumbs up, and your participation via comments, as these all contribute to the popularity of my channel and being selected by sponsors to send their products for review. And for that, I'm forever grateful. Give this video the thumbs up if you enjoyed the review. If you are new to my channel and would like to keep in the loop as to when I release new videos or decide to do a giveaway, do me a favor and hit the subscribe button and the notifications bell directly below this video. Stay tuned and I'll be seeing you in the next one.